That said, folks, here we are at the Bijou Theater, and I have here the Upchuck Cup, a little item passed out by the management to remind you that if you can't take the current double bill of horror films called Frenzy of Blood, that you better not come. Upchuck Cup, try saying that fast.
Upchuck Cup, Upchuck Cup, Upchuck Cup, Upchuck Cup. That's groovy, isn't it? I really grooved on the Upchuck Cup, really far out.
You like the Upchuck Cup?
Oh, really turned me on, you know what I mean?
Did you get sick?
Oh, wow, I got sick. I got sick all over. Oh, wow, really far out.
Oh, why didn't you use your Upchuck Cup?
Oh, it wasn't big enough. I had to use my purse. You want to see?
No, no.
Oh, wow.
This is Howard Scott about to upchuck in my Upchuck Cup.
Groovy.
Dr. Sarcofiguy, and I'm just absolutely tickled brown because you can't see the pink on me because I'm cooked real well. Yes! Oh, we got a wonderful show for you today. We have wonderful shows for you all the time, but today in particular,
Woo!
I didn't...
Did you have a good show today?
Yes,
oh,
we do, for a change.
Hi, Dr. Sarcofiguy.
How you doing, sweetheart? This is dePest.
Well, yes,
what's that you got?
Oh, this is your mail. I went and picked up mail from your house. You know, I really have to keep on top of this. You don't answer your mail quickly enough. He's got fan mail and royalty checks to deposit. Well, I'll take care of that royalty
What do you do? What do you do with my mail?
Well, you don't answer it quickly enough. Look, you've got all these requests for autographs and everything, so I take it upon myself to be your manager. I go into your house, I collect it up, I respond quickly and promptly to your legions of fans, and I just...
There's probably a reason why I haven't responded. I haven't seen my mail in about 2 weeks.
Oh.
You've been opening my... I've gone to my mailbox a couple of times, and I have not seen any mail because you have been getting my mail.
Well, you are a star and a very busy man, and you need somebody to take care of that for you, and really, I just don't...
I was busy most of the time going down to the police station going, why is my mail not coming to my house? Went down to the post office saying, why is my mail not coming to my house? I'm on Chuck. Mail sometimes. There's a coupon.
Oh.
I could have used that for Safeway.
Oh.
That's a safe place to go, Safeway. I feel
Don't worry.
Safe
I will cook your
Safeway.
Meals for you. When I go into your house, I do also make sure that your refrigerator is stocked with good, healthy foods so you stay nice and svelte for television.
You've been going through my fridge, and I was wondering why that turkey sub sandwich was missing. That was my food. You've been I lack half a junk food in my fridge.
No, no.
Mold
no,
on
no.
my mayonnaise.
Oh, I need you to be healthy for our show.
Lord,
I just let myself in whenever I want with this key.
You got a key?
Yes, of course I have a key. How am I supposed to take care of
you
anything without
a
key?
You always do that. You got a webcam in my show and you got a key.
Well, that's what I do. I download the webcam when I go into your house and I make sure that it gets posted immediately so that all your fans can see you in all your glory.
Well, at least I know who to call when I get my keys locked in my car. Apparently, do you have the keys to my car too?
What a good idea.
Oh, Lord, I done gave her an idea. Well, while I get all flustered, as I typically do between breaks, let's go look at that movie. What is it? Shut Eye Hotel. Bob, was that Bill Plimpton?
Oh, he's good.
Yeah, he's real good. I can't
Ooh.
Stand you. Do you have keys to that hotel, too?
No, I use your house as my hotel.
Oh, Lord.
I snuggle into your bed all nice and warm after you leave in the morning.
Oh, Lord, Lord. Now I gotta change the sheets and the towel. It's just not sacred anymore. Oh, just go to the movie. Go. Woman, you get on my nerves. back. You just welcome back to Spooky Movie Television. And you just finished seeing Shut Eye Hotel. Yes.
That was good.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
Now there's something you need to read, honey.
This one?
You need to read that.
I need to read this one. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. Since you like to hold on to my mail, you hold on to that. Mm-hmm. So many.
There's a surprise.
Yeah, I bet you. Let's see what this is. Oh, it's got the official White House stuff on it. Lord have mercy. Well, let me see what it says here. Oh, and it's long, and it's well, look at that. The President Obama is going to come down to the show. He's a big fan of the show, loves you. I don't know why. And it says that, let's see, Dr. Sarcofiguy, please. Please vacate the premises on this particular occasion because...
The president is a big fan of mine.
Yeah, it said that at the beginning. I figured that was just a clerical error. You mean to tell me I can't be on a show, a show that I'm on?
I'm sorry, it's a presidential request.
Shut up with this song. Oh, Linda, she's dancing. I can't stand her dancing. Next, you're going to do your rocket.
I'm so excited to see the president. You know, we share a name. He's Barack Obama.
Yes, that's technically correct. I can't stand you because you almost made me break character with that joke. That was good. But I'm not going to be on a show.
I'm sorry. I'm just going to have to carry it all myself and entertain the president and the first lady. There must be some reason why they don't want you here. Can you think of any reason?
Not offhand. Not really. I can't seem to think of anything why that wouldn't want to have me on the show.
He is kind of hard.
Oh, have mercy.
Oh, boy, I have so much to prepare for. What am I going to wear?
Hopefully you're going to wear a hood over your face and just disappear into a corner. Oh, Lord, this is just horrible.
Jealous. You're so jealous.
Yes, I'm jealous.
It's not attractive on you, honey.
It's very attractive. Let me tell you, y'all just go to the next movie. The next movie is called EXCISION. And I'm gonna sit there and I'm gonna go to a corner and I'm gonna sulk about this. Oh.
And I'm gonna have this framed.
It's gonna have this framed. This is horrible. Where do I go? How do I exit stage left or something?
Oh. Let's go watch the movie.
Mine. Just tell Mom I'll be back later, okay?
Everything all right in there? I'm fine!
Ugh.
dinner. Go wash your hands.
So, Pauline, any idea what you might like for your graduation gift?
A retractor.
A retractor?
Yeah.
What's a retractor?
It's that metal thing that separates the edges of a wound after you've made the incision.
You're not getting a retractor. Concerned about Grace. God knows we don't need another Pauline. I know it sounds terrible, but I am going to be so relieved when she's out of here in a couple months.
Where are they going?
Grace has a doctor's appointment.
You know, Mom, eventually she's gonna need to have a lung transplant. And she can't just have a single transplant because of the risk of infection. She's gonna need to have both.
That day is a long way down the road, Polly.
Well, all I'm saying is it's a pretty serious procedure. And with all the mishaps that happen in hospitals these days, I just... I think you should consider the alternatives.
You know, honey, if you really want to be a surgeon, you're going to have to start working harder at school.
Like a billion people have performed surgery before me. And school is not teaching me anything right now.
Where have you been?
At the library.
I get a call from Mr. Sachs today telling me that you didn't show up for school. And you expect me to believe you were at the library?
Her.
What happened to the doctors today? Did he prescribe you any new medications?
medicine to breathe better.
Obviously. Are you sure you didn't say anything about infection?
We're having early dinner.
I'm not hungry.
Come on, baby. Ugh. Girl. Well, your father and I are meeting some friends for dinner in the city this weekend. Jennifer will be over to look after you guys.
She's 2 years older than me. She's coming over to babysit.
She's a very responsible girl.
You know, it's hard for me to believe that at this time next year, Pauline's going to be away at college.
I'm thinking about taking a year off.
That's a little late in the game for that, Pauline.
And where are you planning on living, here? You used to be so eager to learn. Remember that paper you wrote about ancient Greece?
Highest grade in the class.
Well, I'm not much for the Hippocratic Oath these days.
What does that mean?
I'm not sure even Pauline knows, sweetheart.
What's the Hippocratic Oath?
You're going to college, whether you like it or not. End of discussion.
End of discussion? Why can we not talk about it if I want to...
You okay? Sweetie? Okay. Okay, is everything okay? Jennifer canceled, so your father is staying in. And I'll be home around midnight. Hey, excuse me!
I didn't even know you liked tea.
Yeah, well, maybe if Mom didn't have you on such a tight leash.
Pauline, she's your mother.
Yeah, that's a shame.
Hey. Hey! You want some jump ropes? Yeah, my sister can't use them because of her lungs.
Grace, you're not gonna understand what I'm about to do, but someday you're gonna thank me. Look at the detailed work I did on Grace's sutures. It's really hard at first, but...
What have you done?
Don't worry about that. I can sew her back up. It's okay. It's my first surgery.
Oh, my God!
What? Hurt? Don't worry. I just didn't know what to do with her body after I successfully retrieved her lungs, so I practiced some of my incisions. You should really take a look at her. She's... incredible.
Grab the keys and hit the gas.
You're watching Spooky Movie Television. Boo!
Thank you. It's too dark to take any pictures.
I know.
Then why'd you bring it?
I don't know. Are we almost there?
Are we there yet?
Almost. Okay, here we are. Who's going to do it?
I don't know. But not me, guys. Okay?
You guys, it's not even real.
But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't try. No, it's been working real well for you. Oh, ow. Really, Jess? You know, here, let me give you your knife back because you might want that. You can put that in your knapsack. Sorry, but are you even working right now? Well, technically, no. See? Okay, you know what? Well, at least I'm not stuck in a dead-end job sitting in a cubicle all day.
Yeah, well, I wish I wasn't.
Yeah, well, I wish I wasn't. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Look, you're either going to continue to wish that you weren't, or you're going to take a chance.
Sometimes you fail.
But at least you know you're trying.
So, speaking of failure, Aaron, how about this shortcut?
What are you talking about?
Well, we're lost. Face it.
No, I wouldn't say that.
Oh, yeah? And where are we?
Vermont.
Specifically?
Specifically, in the woods, in Vermont.
I knew I shouldn't have followed you.
Well, you know, you really only have yourself to blame for that one. Hey, come on, look, this path has to go somewhere, right?
That doesn't make me feel any better.
Oh, God, you know what? I can't believe you don't trust your big sister. See, I told you that this path would lead somewhere.
And this is a good thing.
This is a very good thing, because you see, now we know where we are.
A swamp.
Dead creek.
No, it can't be.
Jess, no. Jess, don't start, okay? This is like the last thing we need. Look, this is Dead Creek. We know there's a way out, right? I mean, the camp's just on the other side. We get to that, we get to the road, and we're gone.
I'm not going back there.
What? Why not? Aaron, you...
I'm not going back there.
Okay, you got a better idea?
I don't know. The camp is probably all overgrown with bushes by now. I mean, it's been closed since...
No, I know.
Since that night. Yeah, who knows if we could even find it?
Those are all really good points, Jess, but I asked you if you had a better idea.
I don't know, maybe we could walk around and find the road that way.
It's a great idea. Okay, in case you've forgotten, Dead Creek's huge. It's like 3,000 acres or something.
Sarah died here, Aaron.
Yeah, I know. You're acting like I wasn't there.
You're acting like it doesn't matter.
Of course it matters, Jess. Jess, look. Sarah's dead, okay? And we're out here, and we're lost? Come on, look. We'll get to the camp. We'll hitch your head back into town. We'll be back tonight. I mean, it is our best way of getting out. Come on.
Aaron? What the hell is that?
Moo.
Are you sure it's not like a deer or a moose or something?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. See those things coming out of its head? Those aren't antlers.
How would a cow get way out here?
I don't know.
God, what could do that to a cow?
Oh, probably just got stuck in the mud and died.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Hey, Jess, it's okay. We're gonna be fine. We'll probably be out of here within an hour. It's okay. I mean, we're safe now.
Aaron, I need a minute, all right?
Yeah, sure. Listen, take all the time you need, okay? I'm gonna go see if I can find the road out. Okay? Just take your time, okay? I'll be right back.
Aaron?
I'm so sorry.
Dead Creek. Isn't that a lovely little movie? Oh, I'm just...
I don't know. I'm not even thinking about the movie. I'm just thinking of that the president is coming to Spooky Movie Television and they want to see me. Oh, I'm going to have such a good time chatting with the First Lady.
Yeah. I can see why they won't have me here. Now, let me admit to you why they don't want me on the show when they get here. It's because of Shell.
Shell?
Yeah, me and Shell. Well, I call her Shell because she dressed up like a mermaid. Of course, her name is Michelle, but she dressed up like a mermaid back in the prom.
And ooh, where did she put those shells?
Yeah, she put the shells where you would put them, strategically placed. One was an oyster shell, and one was a mussel shell. But, you know, she was just a young girl. But anyway, she comes at this... Oh, I'm just so upset because I kind of stepped on her tail, and next thing you know, her shells, well, it kind of just fell. And it was just a shame. Why am I repeating myself?
So you mean you dated the First Lady?
Yeah, I dated the First Lady, and I was the last person she probably wanted to see when she came down here.
Oh, my God. If you had stuck with her, you might have been president.
Mm-hmm. President of an ice cream shop. It was in Chicago at the time, and I didn't have really good prospects for any kind of employment. I mean, that's why I'm a horror host making the big bucks.
Oh, wow. I'm hosting a show with someone who could have been president.
I could have been president. I could have been a contender. But I guess I'll just have to just stomach the fact that I can't be on the show. But just give him my love and my apologies. And...
Oh, it's going to be so much fun. I'm going to talk with her about how we both have tall, dark, and handsome mates.
Oh, I'm taller than him.
Oh,
I'm way taller than him. I'm very tall. And, well, you know, I'm a little darker, as you just said, but I'm way taller than him. But I tell you, I'm not going to think about it anymore. You just go ahead and get yourself ready with your little cinched-in dresses and stuff.
Yes, we're going to have such good girl talk. We're going to talk about gardening and fashion and how to get those great-looking upper arm muscles.
Yeah, and I'm just going to have my TV dinner watching the show being all upset. And not going to have seafood either, because all it's going to do is make me cry. No clams and no mussels for dinner that day. It's going to be a hungry man meatloaf dinner. All myself with the little apple brown Betty. I can't think of brown Betty's either. Her name is not Betty, but she's brown, and I don't want to think about it. Anyway, y'all go. Thank y'all for being on the show. Well, not for being on the show, because I'm not going to be on the show either. But I'll talk to you later. Goodbye. I can't stand
Thanks
you.
For watching Spooky Movie Television. Woohoo!
Yeah, that show. Oh, Lord.